See, Captain, this is one of the ball bearings from the broken aft radar mount. How creative, Otto! Look what I've got!
Tinsel? Where'd you find that?
It's not tinsel. It's the electrical cable from the camera probe that got zapped during the meteor storm. I've never seen something so beautifully ruined.
And what do you have there, Sparky? That looks familiar. Where did you find that Christmas tree?
It was in a big metal can down in the environmental bay.
Was that can yellow with big red letters on it that said air supply do not touch?
Yes, it did!
Sparky, that's our filter for breathing air. Without it, we wouldn't last a day.
Oh, does that mean I should put it back? Okay, Robot, you guys sure don't have any Christmas spirit.
Info, back to that decorating status report.
The Christmas decorations are going up. The hot chocolate is just about ready, and we're going caroling for decks 25 through 129 tonight.
And the nativity scene?
We're doing what we can, Captain, but it's not as easy as Christmas decorations.
I'm sure you're all doing great.
We're trying. We're making our own little Bethlehem in outer space.
We are, but I still miss home.
Hey, let's decorate the whole ship!
Yay!
Where are you going, Miss Polo?
Getting my spacesuit! I'm getting outside lights. Where will be my hammer?
Hammer?
Catch her before she goes out. No nails! Is something wrong, Zip?
I just kind of miss Christmas presents. It's nice to know people are thinking about me.
I got you a present. I was going to wait until Christmas, but, well, here.
Wow, what is it?
A candy plate!
The
shape of the gyro that keeps our shirt from being pulled straight into the sun? Maybe I'll get you something else. I was thinking about you.
Food, the candy, the snickerdoodles.
I just wish the cook's snickerdoodles were as good as my mom's.
Our cook doesn't know how to make snickerdoodles.
You're telling me the ones he put out in the lab were as hard as rocks.
Were they black and the size of baseballs?
Yup, and burned through crisps. Ate them all, though.
Great, now we have to get more meteorite samples.
Navigator Polo! Where's the navigator?
She may be lost in the ship again.
Again?
I lost the text in her water on deck 79 about 10 minutes ago.
I thought we gave her the map of the ship.
You know she's not good with maps, Captain.
There you are, Miss Polo. On the bridge, of course.
What a relief! I thought I was done for!
Miss Polo, do you have any idea how we can get back down to Earth?
We have to get us home tonight.
What are you talking about, Miss Polo? That's impossible!
No one has any idea. You know that. Limited to active speed 10. This ship is so powerful that the scientists are afraid to open her up. And if they do, she could disrupt the laws of physics. It could go well over active speed 10 and into hyperactive mode. No one knows what might happen.
If we go 1 mile per hour faster than the speed of light, it could be a disaster. Nobody's ever flown that fast. No! Miss Otto, pull us back. Damage control, report.
It's Earth, we're home.
Yay!
Zip, prepare the Zoom Beam transporter. Let's surprise Penny, our faithful ground control, and beam her up to the ship.
Boy, is she gonna be excited to see us.
Zoom Beam ready.
Oh no!
But isn't that the guy on the penny?
We went too fast. We warped time. He went backwards in time.
How far?
4 score and 7 years.
More like 200 years. Zip. Beat Mr. Linking back down and fast. Apparently going faster than the speed of light wasn't a good thing. Now we're time travelers. That'll get you home, crew.
Right around the Sea of Galilee, and Moses' ministry was in the Galilean region. Well, far of course for Galilee, in the town of King.
back to God.
All the amazing lights in space that we've been seeing are God's handiwork, the Bible says. Before Jesus was born, the prophet said, "To those who walk in darkness, a great light has dawned." That was talking about Jesus, the light of the world.
That's right. If you want to know what God says, it's all right here. It's all in the book.
Info, status please.
Captain, we're in Earth's orbit.
It may be Earth, but what year?
I'm clear on where we are, just not when.
Turn on the viewport, Sparky. Let's see who they are. Sparky, where are we? When are we? Give Roma an audio feed to see if she can decipher their language. Is about to become man as a baby, and the first ones who will know him are the shepherds.
What's exactly going to happen?
According to Luke, there were shepherds nearby living out living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks at night. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the God shone around them, and they were terrified.
It's night in Bethlehem. The angels could arrive at any time.
Should we stop them, Captain?
No. We don't want to interfere in any way.
It's so quiet down there.
Did anyone else hear something?
The shepherds are looking well. Do they see us?
Impossible, but they do seem to see something.
Wow!
What was that flash?
There, an angel. I see it. Listen.
Thousands of angels.
Christ, the very Son of God.
That was unbelievable. Can you move in closer? I want to see their faces.
Very well. Miss Otto, move us carefully into the lower orbit. Computer, say we are.
We are still over Earth.
See, no problem. We're still over Bethlehem.
But the computer's not programmed to tell us when we are.
Info, engage the viewport.
It's Jen by the hyperactivity.
Very well. Beam up a life form, Zip. That to tell us when we are.
I'm telling you, it's fine.
Zapping the zoom beam.
Hey, catching up on these hepcats. Dig those crazy duds.
I am Captain Magellan of the spaceship Emmanuel. This is my crew and our robot.
Spaceship? Are you trying to grab my cage?
Excuse us for 1 second, please. Robot, what is she saying?
I may have to put this language in my database, and I might be able to communicate with this group.
Hey, Quark, what puzzle was it?
Cats! How am I going to take his job?
She's impressed that I can speak her language.
We zapped you, and now we're in no one's world. We need you to blow this bird, but we need you to slip us the low. Where are we? Who is she, robot?
I'm afraid this is a version of English spoken in the mid-20th century, and this person might just be a grandma.
What has she got in her hand?
This is my transmitter radio. I was just listening to my fave song, Johnny Angel.
Uh-oh, I used the coordinates singing an angel to move closer to Bethlehem. I guess I should have been more specific.
I just had a thought. First, beam this Hepcat back down. We're on a mission to see the glory of God out in the universe, and we're good at finding stars. So why don't we just navigate to the Star of Bethlehem? The star would have created a huge light in the sky 2,000 years ago. Sparky, scan for the remnants of the energy from that light. Miss Paula, program the computers with these Bible chapters. Matthew, chapter 2. Luke, chapter 2. Miss Otto, send us. Miss Otto, status report. Good. Any minute now, we should be coming into the time of the wise men. I can't believe.
Look at the billboard! What is it?
It's the star! Follow it!
Thank you.
back on the ship.
Man, eyes don't dig. You ran up on your hot rod, and when I blinked, I was all like green. But I made Jackson Guard get in. Here I am.
Robot, translate, please.
To the river, you're not being back on the earth, but to our regiment.
So now we're stuck with her? We can't beat a redundant over the mid-20th century.
Miss Polo, detour back to the 20th century.
Aye, aye, Captain. Captain.
Very well. Viewport on.
Captain, we're back in Bethlehem. There are sheep, cows, and donkeys. It's like a zoo.
Shepherds, sheep, a manger? That must be his mother Mary, and that would be Joseph. And there's the infant child. We're back, but how did this happen?
I'm not sure, but I'm not going to miss this again. Miss Otto, prepare a shore party.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Zoom beam Officer Zip, you stay on the bridge. Everyone else, come with me to the surface. Hurry.
Maybe he's abundant.
I don't know what to say.
This is the most amazing thing I've ever seen.
The birth of the Savior. Let's go.
Yeah. Yes, we do.
What? Where are we?
You are in Bethlehem.
See?
Bethlehem, Pennsylvania.
What year is this?
Well, 1741, of course.
Captain, I'm guessing you want me to aim the ship
Don't forget to make a quick stop at the 1950s so Miss Hepcat can make it back at her hot stop.
Thanks, Daddy-o.
And just like I told you, we're gonna be home for Christmas.
Miss Fuller, better hang a left at the 1950s and swing by the 1860s real quick. Thank you to our special cameos. Shepherd One, Mr. Sifferman. Shepherd Two, Father Jose. Shepherd Three, Father Mike. Abraham Lincoln, Mr. Moakley. Sandy was played by Michaela Bigda. Otto was played by Hope Snoozy. Zip was played by Ella Lewers. Info was played by Andy Gatton. Sparky was played by Sophia Buffoni. Robot was played by Stella Detilla. Polo was played by Abby Beaton. would like to thank the following: our sound crew, Thomas Noly and Riley Shea. Mrs. O'Brien, our costume director. Mrs. Johnson, our director. The faculty and staff for the time spent on practice. Our administration, Mrs. McDonough, Mr. Moakley, and Mr. Sipperman for their assistance. Monsignor Mike and Father Jose for their help and humor. Mrs. Beltran for her help with music. The video club for their tapping of our afternoon performance under the direction of Mrs. Ethier and Liz Poplowski for their Shrewsbury Media Connection. Mrs. Filmer and her technology classes for set design. Mrs. Zybert, Mrs. Mahoney, Mrs. Kylie, for the help with sets. Yes. Please stand when your class is called to take a bow. Kindergarten. Grade 1. Grade 2. Grade 3. Grade 4. Grade 5. Grade 6. Grade 7. Grade 8. Once again, the cast and crew of In a Galilee Far, Far Away.